Hello, 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 hello. All right, man. Well, the last video that I posted, I was at Laredo at the terminal. I had gotten a pre-assignment on the way down, and I dropped off my trailer at one of the forwarding companies that take it across the Mexican border into Mexico. There's a lot of them. There's tons of them. I lost count a long, long time ago. It looks like about 15 more take a spot. Every time they build a road over in Laredo, they fill it up with those people that take it across the border back and forth. A lot of money in it, I guess. Well, I'll tell you, that trailer that I dropped off on the driver tech on the paper that I wrote down, I thought I'd made a mistake. I went back and checked it, but on the order information, it said it was due today by 3:30. And I say today, is it after midnight? Yeah, it's after midnight here, so yesterday by 3:30. But once I got inside the terminal after I dropped it, they asked me, "You haven't dropped that trailer, have you?" I was like, "Yeah, I delivered it, you know, about 10 minutes early, actually. 15 minutes early. I was actually there before that, but I was sitting in line waiting to get in." So he's like, "Man, that thing wasn't due until tomorrow." I'm like, "Not according to my paperwork." So, you know, there's that. It wasn't my load. If you'll remember, I repowered that load up in Irving. You know, a dude brought it from somewhere and brought it down to me at Irving. I got it and I took it down there to the forwarder who's going to forward it across the border and take it even further. About 600 miles inland, I think. So, I didn't know. Nobody told me. They just told me when they wanted it down there, and the destination wasn't the Laredo terminal. The destination was that forwarding company. They probably should have pointed that out if that's what they wanted or how they wanted it. Not much being said notwithstanding, I don't care. I did what I was told to do. Got it from point A to point B on time or early. That's what you do in this business. That is this business. It's all about moving freight from point A to point B on time or early. Now remember, here's your nugget. This is cool. I think it's got something to do with the military, but anyway. This is something I say, I teach all my students, but I say it over and over and over and over and over, even in my private life. On time and early and late. Those three terms. Remember those. This is how they break down. Early is on time. On time is late, and late is unacceptable. And if you'll remember that in the trucking business, remember, early is on time. On time is late. And late is unacceptable. You remember that? Just get it from point A to point B early, which is on time. You're good to go. Moving forward, of course, that pre-assignment that I mentioned earlier in this video was sitting at the Laredo terminal. And I went parked, I had to bobtail back because they didn't have any empties at that freight forwarding place when I dropped the trailer there. So I went over, I got my paperwork, and in the video I'm holding up, I'm actually pointing at my truck with the paperwork. I had it in my hand. I had just come out of the terminal and got the paperwork for the trailer. And I went ahead and did a little 30 minute break and stuff like that, and then I was going to go find the trailer just in case it put me on the drive line. You never know about these electronic logging devices. You never know what they're going to do. And that terminal's so big that weaving back and forth between the trailers, looking for your trailer at any given time, you never know. It might put you on the drive line. So I needed to make sure that I completed that 30-minute break, and it reset that 8-hour clock. And if it didn't put me on the drive line, it would keep me in the break status. But I started weaving and looking for that trailer, and I found it, and I put in that I was pre-tripping, got out, pre-tripped the trailer and everything like that, still waiting on my order to come through. What I didn't know was not only was it shift change or thereabouts with the fleet managers, but the system went down. on their end, they couldn't send or receive the order. They had limited access to anything. Couldn't see orders. Couldn't see all kinds of things. And in the truck, you know, everything is what it is. It's remote, and things are sent to the driver tech, and everything's the way it is at the truck until something changes from the outside and it's sent in. But the electronic logging devices have nothing to do with the order entry and how it comes and all that. The driver tech combines it all, puts it all together in one big package with a GPS and other stuff, but it has nothing to do with all that. So I can roll. I can make myself legal because I've got a bill of lading in my hand. I've got the freight, and I've got a way to log it. And that's what I did. I waited, and I called them, sent messages, and was on hold for a while. But finally, I got through, and I'm like, dude, send me my order, man. He's like, there's something wrong with the system. It's still down, and blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, okay, I got to go. So I left, and I had made it almost to San Antonio before the system came back up, and messages started coming through again and everything like that. And I was able to pull over, accept the order, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Unfortunately, I was about 10 or 15 miles north of my first fuel stop when all that went down, but I got a lot of fuel. My truck, it doesn't burn a whole lot of fuel. It really doesn't. It gets pretty good gas mileage, or pretty good fuel mileage. I almost fell into that one. It's not gas, it's diesel, it's fuel. It gets pretty good fuel mileage. So, you know, I still had a half tank, which is 100 gallons. I'm good to go, man. I could probably, at 5 miles to the gallon, 100 gallons, I can go 500 miles. So my next fuel stop, you know, it wasn't but 300 and some odd miles away. I can make it, no big deal. And if I need to stop in between, I can always call the fuel department, and they'll give me a location close to me to stop at. It's not that big a deal. So this, you know, I'm rolling with this order. These are nuggets, man. I'm giving you some good stuff here, man. Teach you what to do, so you're not just sitting there with your thumb up your butt trying to figure out what to do, losing time, losing money. You don't want to do that. You gotta go. I wasted enough time there. But I, you know, we got a scale there, so I was able to scale the load. It's really heavy, and I figured whenever I hooked up to it and I looked at where the tandems were, the pins were set, and the squat on the tires, you know, with regards to the tandems on the trailer and the drives on the truck. I was looking at, you know, comparing the squat and everything like that, both sides. You got to do it both sides. Trailer was at a little bit of an angle, so I was getting more squat on the truck. I'm like, I don't think it's that heavy on the front right there, because the tandems, they were moved almost all the way forward. I'm like, nah, if so, they're gonna have to transload that thing, rework the load. So I moved on out and leveled out the truck, then eyeballed it, and then we're good to go. I'm like, yeah, that'll work. And then when I carried it across the scale, you know, there was only 500, maybe 1,000 pounds more on the drives than on the tandems. It was well within limits, and definitely not over gross. It was not over 80,000, more like a 76,000-78,000, something like that. It was pretty heavy, but it wasn't over, so we're good to go. I tore ass. Woof. And I'm just watching the clock, trying to figure out where I was going to make it to, and I had about an hour left on my 14-hour clock when I pulled in here at the pilot here in Waco. I'm not going to chance it, because I know the Flying J is going to be packed. I'm not going to be able to get in there. And this place was actually packed, too. There's no parking places, but they have idle air. Another little golden nugget for y'all. Anywhere that's got idle air, not everybody has idle air cards. And you can generally count on there being at least one spot open at an idle air. Not always, not everywhere. Kind of funny around Carlisle, Pennsylvania, you know, that those idle airs will fill up real fast. Not a single idle air hose is in a single window. Not one of them aero conditioning things and all the other things that come with it. Not a single one of them in a single window. They just fill up them spots over there. But that it is what it is over there. There's three or four major, huge, big truck stops, and they're always full at night. So it is what it is. So I got in here, and I shut down, and I was talking with my buddy Joshua. There's your shout out, Josh. And when I was shopping in Lawton, Oklahoma for the truck, he said I needed to get some jalapeno spam. Now, I like spam. Okay, so don't hate me, man, and don't hate on spam either. If you don't like it, you don't like it. I don't care. I do. My kid, one or two of my kids do also. But he said you need to get some of that jalapeno spam, so I did. But it's been rolling around in the truck, and I hadn't eaten it until tonight. And I sliced that dude up some really big, thick slices, threw it on a couple pieces of bread because I was hungry, and I'm tired. I don't want to go to bed. I don't want to mess with cooking some food and everything. And it was good. Had a little bit of spice to it, but it still tasted like spam. So we're good to go. Yeah. That was Din Din, man. Made it real quick and ate it real quick, too. And now I'm going to bed. I just want to touch base with y'all again before I shut things down, because something happened today and I wanted to share that with y'all. This mental midget, I'm going to try to be nice talking about him or her, whatever he is. I don't know, because I called him all kinds of things. This mental midget decided he was going to play he was just trying to be a dick, and he wanted to make a negative comment, not on just one, but one comment per video, something like that. There was a couple comments, and I saw him when I first woke up this morning. I was like, oh no, another troll. I've been without trolls for a while. One of them oozed to the surface, popped like a nasty boil on your butt, and oozed his crap. So I was feeling a little feisty this morning, so I was like, oh goody, because you need practice every once in a while. You got to keep your form, you got to make sure you still have it, because see, this is chess, not checkers. You got to think ahead, and if I'm going to make a comment, I'm gonna reply to a troll. I already know what they're going to say at the other end, so I already have something saved up for them. And he took the bait. I threw the bait out there. He took the bait. He brought it in, and I hit him again, and I left it there for a while, cause I don't know. He's a special kind of stupid, I guess. Yeah, he's a special kind of stupid. I made a lot of funny comments to myself. I didn't actually post them, but I made a whole host of funny comments to myself. I had a whole lot of stuff saved up for him all day long. He made my day. I want to thank him. He's gone now. He's blocked. But I want to thank him for being the dick that he is, because he put me in a fairly good mood. I was kind of tired when I woke up, but not after I saw that. So I got going in the morning. Then I get some notifications on my phone that somebody made comments, but I didn't look at it till I stopped. And I just turned on the whatchacallit here, and I'm like, what in the world? I got not just your average everyday troll, I got a super trucker troll. And that's assuming he's ever been inside a truck. Just super trucker wannabe troll. I'm like, what the hell is this? You're doing it wrong. Did you watch the video, dickhead? Asshat, dumbass, did you watch the video? And a foot is no, that won't work. Down south, y'all should stay down there. Dude didn't watch the video. He must not have. Or if he did watch it, he has no comprehension. Or it didn't stick in there, flowed out of his ears. Another asshat. Two asshats. Two trolls in one day. And that's rare. Rare. Ah! I didn't give him the time of day. I just blocked his ass. I sent him down the road, kicked him to the curb. Little bitch that he is. Tell him to go crawl back in his mama's basement. Stop coming up unless he's got permission. And he ain't got permission from me. People are lucky I'm not as violent as I used to be. People are lucky. Because I'm like Liam Neeson. I have a certain set of skills. And they make me very dangerous to a dickhead like that. If I can get my hands on. But, you know, I got grandchildren. They need to see Grandpa being happy and fat and jolly and everything, visiting with them. They don't need to come visit me in the jailhouse through some glass or some wire or something. So we'll let him make it this time. We'll let them all make it. Trolls, they just kick you to the curb. I don't give you time of day. Just block, block, block. Unless I need to practice, unless I feel like I need to practice, then I'm gonna get on there and I'm gonna make you cry. I'm gonna make you cry, and you're gonna call your mom, and she's probably gonna come try to whoop my butt, cause you can't, cause you're just a troll. They let you out of the basement for 5 minutes, and look what you got into. Now you gotta crawl back in the basement. That much being said, notwithstanding, it's been a great day. I put on almost 600 miles today alone. I didn't realize it. I took my 14 down to the last hour and had about an hour of drive time left, a little over an hour of drive time, and 584 miles. I was killing it today. I was killing it. So I didn't feel it until towards the end, but now I'm feeling it. So I might have to break out them BC powders here in just a minute. All right, I'm glad. I'm sharing with y'all, and y'all are commenting and y'all are thumbs up, and I'm seeing it. It's working. It's working. No thumbs down. I'll come get you. Thumbs up. There you go. There you go. You know what it means. Thumbs up. It doesn't mean you like the video. That's not what it's for. It propagates the system. I think that's the right way to say that. It helps the algorithm decide what videos are relevant on YouTube, so other people get to see these things. Thumbs up doesn't mean I like the video. Thumbs up means I want to share it with everybody. And then of course you hit share on your social media or share on there or whatever, and then it goes to your Facebook, and then other people start watching it and they're like, hey, that bald-headed dude in that truck, man, he's pretty funny. And then they start watching on a regular basis, and they start thumbs up, and then it spreads to even more. And then these little nuggets that I give you every once in a while, I call attention to these little learning pieces for the truck drivers, especially the newbies and the folks just getting into the business, and some that have been around a while, but you know, they don't want to ask any questions. They're afraid to ask anybody because they might look like, I don't know, like they don't know what they're talking about, or they might look like a newbie and they're not, or a rookie or whatever. There's no harm in that, man. If you don't know, you don't know. Ask. I didn't know. I didn't have YouTube. I had to depend on old codger, know-it-all, put you down for the least little question kind of dickheads back in the day, man. You ask them a question, they look at you like you're stupid, like, why would you ask that? It's common sense. You do this, this. No, it's not freaking common sense. It's trucking, and I didn't grow up a truck driver. I had a stepdad who was a truck driver for a couple years, but my mom and him broke up, and then I didn't see him anymore. And I rode with him in a truck, you know. I loaded the frozen shit on the pallets. I remember all that, but he didn't teach me how to drive. I mean, I drove the truck, but he didn't teach me how to drive a truck, and he didn't teach me how to be a truck driver, and I wasn't around him long enough to pick it up. you got to ask questions. You got to watch and learn and all that. And that's what this is all about. I'm trying to help people. I'm trying to spread this stuff because I get one student at a time in here for a month. You know, 12 a year, thereabouts, maybe more. That's the way this works. I don't get to reach out and touch 30 people at a time in a little truck driving school. You know, I get to touch one a month, maybe. You know, I get to take everything I can remember, because I've forgotten more than I teach. I get to, you know, pass it on, and it feels good. It feels good, especially when the light bulb goes on and they get it, and they go out and they become professionals, and they do what I tell them to do, and they, man, sometimes they don't. And then they call me later, hey man, this and this and this, and I need to ask you a question. This happened, and I'm like, didn't listen to me, did you? Gotta listen. Use your brain. Let it go in. Stay there. Use your brain. Listen. Give you these golden nuggets, man. This is the way I do things. This is the way I've been doing it for years, for decades. You know, don't mess around. Just listen. Take it. Shape it. Mold it. Make it your own. Do it your way. But listen to the important stuff. It's important. Safety. Whole 360. The whole everything that I give you. I'm not trying to hurt anybody. I'm trying to help. Yeah, listen. Take it to heart. Put it in your brain. Listen. It's important. All right. I done held y'all too damn long again. I'm sorry. I get on these little tirades, you know. But I'll be leaving for Illinois in the morning. Also, Illinois. It's up there. Basically, if you've ever heard of the south side of Chicago, yeah, Alsop is right there. Right by the south side of Chicago. Just a little suburb, little hiccup right south of Chicago. So that's where I'm going. And I got over 1,055 miles left to go from here, according to Garmin. So, can't do it in one day. It'll be 2 days. But I'll still have some drive time and some 14 left on the second day. So I'll probably get a pre-assignment day after tomorrow. Today is Wednesday, so I'll drive all day Thursday, shut down like I am now, and then drive all day Friday evening. I get it up there. I think it's due on Friday. 9 o'clock. 9 a.m., 9 p.m., something. Maybe 9 p.m. Friday. I think I'm going to get it there on time. I think. I'm not sure. We'll see. Hopefully I won't run into any traffic. Alright then. Appreciate visiting with y'all. I really do. I love it. And appreciate when y'all watch. Thumbs up. You like. You share. You comment. I love those comments. If you haven't subscribed yet, remember, hit that subscription thingy. Hit the little bell so you know when I come on and I'm talking. And I can share this stuff with you. Maybe we can get this to spread out a little bit and I can touch more people. Yeah. All right. We'll see you down the road.